Welcome to Double Take with Double R. Friday morning, 8:37 por la mañana. I got to throw in my Spanish here a little bit, man. Hey. Mi español. You know, I get a kick out of some of the people that live here in San Antonio when I'm doing the Uber thing. I talk with them and everything. And do you know any Spanish? No. Really? And you're Hispanic? Sí. And you don't know any Spanish? No, and I go, man, you got to learn some kind of Spanish, man, living here in San Antonio, South Texas. Got to be up to date with your Espanol. You really, really do. Anyways, like I said, 8:37 in the morning, Friday morning, January the 27th, 2023. I like to throw in the year to remind me that I'm not back in the year 1978, 77, 76. Man, I sure do miss those years. I really, really do. Anyways, you're probably going, Robert, what about the 80s? What about them? The 80s killed disco music. They really did. Anyways, let's see what's going on out here. Now, first things first, playoff football this Sunday. There we go. We got two games going on. The first game, both games will be played this Sunday. The first one will be played at 2 p.m. Central Standard Time. The Niners and the Eagles. Who am I pulling for? I really don't care. I don't have a dog in the fight. No le hace. It doesn't matter. Should be a pretty good game. Should be interesting. But the one that I really want to see will be the game right after that at 5:30 between the Cincinnati Bengals and the Kansas City Chiefs. That's going to be one for the record books. It really, really is. And that's this is all happening Sunday afternoon. We'll be talking more about Sunday here in just a little bit. It's been one of those kind of weeks, man. I'm telling you, it really, really has. Man. I'm like, man. But it is Friday. I got to tell y'all, man, that lately I've gotten used to drinking micheladas. I don't know what it is about them, but I'm really starting to enjoy them more and more and more. Just in case you don't know what a michelada is, it's where you fill up a glass with ice, you put some Tabasco sauce, you know, a little twist of lime, salt around the rim, maybe a couple of olives, throw in some beer in there, some Clamato juice with some beer, your beer preference, usually an import beer. And I'm telling you, man, I simply love them. It's not like if I just discovered them. For some reason, I've embraced them more now than I did back in the day. Why? I really don't know, but they go down good. Now, that being said, check this out. A 29-year-old woman was arrested after posing as a high school student and attending class. Why would you want to do this, man? I mean, the last thing anybody wants to do is go back to school once you're done with it, right? It's true. It really, really is, man. Remember going to junior high, high school? Man, you couldn't wait to get the hell out of there. But this woman here at 29 decided to pose as a student and go to class. What's her problem? You know, my daughter, I love her with all my heart. My youngest daughter, boy, I got to tell you, man, it was a wrestling match trying to get her to finish school. I said, mija, you're going to finish your school. You're going to graduate. No, Dad, I'm tired of it. Mija, you're going to finish school. You're going to graduate. And finally, right, she graduated. And about 5 years later, we're having lunch. And she goes, you know what, Daddy? And I go, what, mija? I miss going. Cállate, por favor. Now you miss school? I miss school, Dad. Anyway. Man, let's see here what else is going on. Now, check this out. An 81-year-old Florida woman went on a rampage after she was being arrested in Florida. Well, while she was being arrested, she decided to kick the cop in the groin. There you go. Nothing like an 81-year-old rampaged senior citizen. I got to tell you, man, that cop was down for the count. According to witnesses, they say when the cop finally was brought up and, you know, they lifted him up and everything, tried talking to him. What happened, officer? What happened? She sounded just like Cindy. Well, should I say, he sounded just like Cindy Lauper. So there you go. So obviously the woman nailed him in the bullseye. There we go. I get a kick out of it, man. I don't mess with senior citizens. You're probably going, Robert, you're a senior citizen. Yeah, but I'm a young senior citizen, so that makes a difference right there. I young. Right. I'm a young senior citizen, aka Disco Duck. There we go. Now, WWE Wrestling is in town this weekend for a big monster pay-per-view Royal Rumble at the Alamo Dome. How many people are expected? All I know that the Alamo Dome can hold 65,000 people. It would not surprise me that if 60 time 65,000 people attend the event. Very, very popular WWE. I'm old school, man. You know, I really don't watch wrestling anymore. I used to, not no more. I'm old school. I used to like the Hulk Hogan, the Ultimate Warrior, Ric Flair, right? The Von Erichs, Jose Lothario, Wahoo McDaniels. Those are the wrestlers that I remember. The ones from today, but like I said, people seem to like it still, so that's all that matters now. Anyways, it's going to be happening Saturday night here at the Alamo Dome. Get your tickets if you haven't already. Now, also, if you don't want to make the wrestling event, but you want to check out some of your favorite stars, now let me give you some lowdown here. There is going to be, what's going on with my throat? There is going to be on Saturday in the morning at River Center Mall. Yeah, River Center Mall on Bowie. They're going to be having a whole mess of wrestlers showing up to sign autographs. Now, here's the kicker. Here's the kicker. They will sign autographs. It's free to go in, but they will sign autographs, and but you got to pay for the autograph or to take a picture with them. $40, as low as 40, and can go as high as $150. That's a lot of money, man. I don't think I would want to do that. I really, really don't. Now, let me see here. Where's the autograph signing? Bleep, 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 bleep. Now, let me give you some of the lowdown here. The Undertaker is going to be at Techport on Friday starting at 10 p.m. He'll be sharing stories and stuff like that. By the time you're seeing this, it'll be over with. But anyways, he would have been there, and tickets go as $35. Rey Mysterio will be at Cricket Wireless on Saturday. There we go. 1848 Southwest WW White Road on Saturday. He'll be there from 9 to 11. Also, the Big E, the new member, will be at the Walmart. The former WWE champion will be at the Walmart, 3302 Southeast Military Drive on Friday. What time? At 1 p.m. Might still have time for that one. And there you go. They got a whole lot of stuff going on. Autograph signings and stuff like that. I think it's really, really cool what they do. I understand, you know, they got to make their money too, one way or the other. It's just how bad do you want your autograph? How bad do you want their autograph? How bad do you want their picture? Right? Hey. Not me. Maybe if it would be one person, if I could pick one person, it would be Hulk Hogan. It would be Hulk Hogan, man. I'm a Hulkster, right? Hulkamania. I'll never forget when they first started doing pay-per-views. I'll never forget when that cable guy came to my apartment and gave me this box. And I said, "What's this?" This was in the 80s, 82, 83, I put I, right? "What's this, sir?" "Oh, that's going to be something for something called pay-per-view." "What's that?" "That's where you can watch certain live events, certain movies, whatever, but you got to pay for them separately." I'll never do that. And then, lo and behold, WrestleMania, the original one, came out. I think it was like $49. It was pretty much the price of my monthly bill for one event. Did I pay for it? Of course I did. Hey, man, like I said, simply love wrestling. Then my son was really into it as well. We would go to all the wrestling matches that would happen here in San Antonio, man. I miss those times. I really, really do. To me, like I said, call me old school. Wrestling isn't the same the way it used to be anymore. Now, here we go. Check this out. I'm going to give you all a fun fact here. You probably wonder, like I probably wonder, how much do fast food restaurant employees get paid? You know, like McDonald's, Kentucky Fried Chicken. How much do they actually get paid? Well, I'm going to give you some lowdown here about how much they get paid. Let's do it here. Now, McDonald's, at the lowest level, they'll make $9 an hour, probably for the rookies. Now, for the ones that we'll call them veterans, they make as much as $12 an hour. Now, as well for that, department managers can make an average of $12 an hour. that doesn't sound like too much for me, but I'm not working there, so I don't need to know about it. Burger King. Let's see what they pay. $9, they're pretty much right there. You can make as much as $11. Wow. I get it. Usually it's the kids, man. The kids are the ones that are working, doing their thing. And so they say that operations managers for Burger King can make as much as $67,000 a year. Yeah, but they live there. They sleep there overnight. Really, man, they put in a lot of hours. They really, really do. Let's see here. Kentucky Fried Chicken. Base pay, pretty much the same, $9. They can make an average of $12 an hour, even up to $14 an hour. They're about all the same. Subway, right? $5 foot long. Well, anyways, $5 foot longs. Average pay is $9 at Subway. A little bit more. Store managers make $12 an hour. Man, well, anyways, let's say that some Subways, they have cash bonuses. And they also make tips. There we go. Subway employees, good for them. And I'll give y'all one more here. Wendy's. Do y'all remember the Wendy's? What was it that, that ice cream deal? What is it? A Wendy's float? No, Wendy's, I forgot what it's called. Well, anyways, people at Wendy's, pretty much, they make $9. They're all pretty much about the same. I think they're all working together or something. Supervisors seem to make like about $11 an hour. There we go. Managers can make up to $56,000 a year. More power to them. There we go. Anyways, let's get to it. Let me talk about Sunday. This Sunday, there we go. The first Cruising Classic Show will be back. From 7 to 10 p.m. Central Standard Time, I will be providing the link for that for everybody to listen in. I'll be providing it on my website right around 6:30, where you can click on it and listen in. But like I said, the show doesn't start till 7. Remember, it's going to be a different kind of a player, but it'll be able to be, you know, you can play it on your phone, whatever the case may be, Bluetooth it, whatever. It'll be a different kind of player. It'll be simple to the point, but you'll be able to listen in to the Cruising Classic Show. It all starts this Sunday from 7 to 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. Then I'll be doing one more Cruising Classic the following week, right? Everybody can listen in, and definitely we're going to make the pitch to try to get subscribers. That's the only way this is going to work. Need subscribers, and you can always subscribe. You can subscribe early by going to robertrivasradio.com, and you'll see the subscribe buttons right there with the options. Then, of course, Super Bowl Sunday. You know, everybody just stops everything to watch the Super Bowl, and I'll be doing the same. And the very, very first subscriber Cruising Classic Show will be happening the following Sunday after that. I think that's February the 17th. I don't know. We'll figure that one out as we get closer. But anyways, it's the weekend. Hopefully everybody is geared up for the weekend. I am, and always great to have the weekend in front of us, right? Somebody told me, I said, Robert, will you be doing possibly one quick morning show? No morning shows. Only we'll be putting the spotlight for right now. We need subscribers. We'll be putting the spotlight on the Cruising Classic Shows. And, of course, the freebie number one will be this Sunday from 7 to 10 p.m. Be sure and join me. Anyways, that's it for me, everybody. Y'all have an awesome weekend. Thank you for joining me with, what am I called again? Oh, yeah. Hey, man, I lose it sometimes. Double Take with Double R. Have an awesome weekend.